Hey guys, Retronator here, back again with another video. Today I am going to be playing GoldenEye 007 on the Nintendo 64. We're going to be doing We're going to be doing the facility level. Level on Secret Agent again. And yeah, let's do this. Our objectives are to gain entry to the laboratory area, contact Double Agent, rendezvous with 006, destroy all tanks in bottling room, to minimize scientist casualties. I never really worry about that one since you just don't kill the scientists. I'm also going to show you guys the secret in this video. I remember I called it last video an Easter egg. I'm pretty much going to call it a secret, maybe like a mistake since it wasn't made to be there. Missed. Shot his hat off. I always liked how detailed that was. You could shoot your hats off. Found that to be really cool. The secret isn't that far from here right now.
Yeah.
It's pretty easy to get to right in the beginning. And the trick to doing this, I always thought this was super hard, but you have to be like stealthy in doing this. You don't want to get caught or else they're all gonna find you, and that was kind of bad. I hope they didn't hear that. But yeah, you just have to be stealthy pretty much, and it's just pretty easy. It's right here. The ventilation shafts or whatever. There are test tubes up there. Oh, what the heck? Excuse me. I'm making a YouTube video. I'm showing my viewers a secret. So there are like test tubes and like science equipment. So if you listen closely, you might be able to hear. Well, never mind, but they shatter. So just cool secret. I don't know why they're up there. I think they were a mistake. That was a mistake. And now they've all found me. Which stinks. I'll just pull out my AK now, like Soviet. Yeah, if they find you, it's just pretty self-explanatory. They're all in here, pretty much, so it's easy. There's also the body armor, which is nice. When I first got this game, I don't know why, I found this so hard to time this right so that you can actually get in. I messed it up. Go back, you have to time this perfectly. Get my security door activated. Go in here, boom. You kill a person right next to him, but he doesn't even notice. Boom. Everything explodes in this game. I thought this was cool too, the way they just like walk up to you like that in their firing position. I don't know why. Just think that's cool, all three of them coming up here. So, where you rendezvous with the scientist or the secret agent? Not 006, but you have to find it. He's randomly in a room. Like, I think there are four rooms that he can be in, so it's pretty much just luck if you find him or not, which sucks for speedrunners because you just have to guess. And the way that you get the cheat codes in this game is by the way you get the cheat codes in this game is by completing the levels in a certain amount of time, and it's hard to do that for this level since you have to be lucky. Guess the first room, since you have to beat it in 4 minutes. This part, you just stand here by the door and all the enemies will just come shooting at you. There are a lot of them, it's crazy. You'd probably die if the reload wasn't so fast. You just pull your gun down and no idea. You have no idea what happens after that. It's fast. So you pretty much have an infinite clip. You never really is an inconvenience to have to reload. If you were to shoot these things and they were to explode and break, you wouldn't be able to beat the level though. It stinks. Unless you guys open the door for you, which is sometimes cool. If you something breaks or you don't have the security card, just shoot the door and then maybe someone will open it for you. Like, see, I accidentally reloaded because I have this problem where if I shoot a bullet, I have to reload immediately. A lot of people have that problem. So, yeah. It's not a problem in this game since it's so fast. So, pretty good. Door is locked. Oh, I'm supposed to use the, it's called a door controller. Sweet. Okay. No. Oh, dang it. Was he supposed to give me something? Oh, there we go. Works. So I'm just gonna do this part like it happened in the movie. I'm actually gonna play it out and not skip everything. Place the mines on this. Yeah. So he, like, he'll talk to you during the games and stuff. So if I wanted to, I could blow up the bombs right now. But, I'm just gonna have you guys see what it looks like. It's a long time for you guys to say like four words. Okay, now the siren's going off. Just like the movie. Same words, same everything. Bad guys will start pouring out. And yeah. I'm also gonna do it like the movie and gonna escape through the like thing here. I don't know what it is. It's like I always thought of it as something like where you put your luggage in like an airport almost. So, throw down your weapons, you are surrounded, and then he'll, like, take Trevelyan and, like, pretend to die. Like, there's nothing you can do here, by the way. You can't surrender at all. So, yes, this happens. Yeah. You can move as close as you want to, but, like, they're not gonna shoot until he counts down. Okay, then you killed him on two, first off. So then you blow the bombs, wait for them to fully explode, D completed, good. Then you can go down here and you finish level. D level. Yeah. Pretty cool. The next level is the runway level, and I'll actually do that now, a little like double episode. Two missions in it, which is pretty cool. This one's fun because you can get a tank in it, and you can like, blow things up, so it's cool. So, like, our objectives are to get the plane key. I think I remember this one. Get the plane key, you have to destroy something, and then you have to just escape in the plane. I love the stealth factor about this game. It's just cool. You can get all this new gear and stuff. Yeah, the plane key is in here, so you get the plane key, and then you go, well, I'm gonna get the tank since it's so fun. So I have two more James Bond games to play after I finish GoldenEye. There's another one on the Nintendo 64 called The World Is Not Enough, and then one on the Wii, which is called just GoldenEye 007 Reloaded, so it's like the same game. But, like, new, like, pretty much, like, how would I say this? Like, just new maps almost. Like, they redid the game, and, like, it's completely different, though, so it'll be, like, a new game to play. So I could play all of those games, and for the one on the Wii, there's a multiplayer feature. Well, there's a multiplayer feature on all of them, but I don't have two Nintendo 64 controllers. So, I might play multiplayer with a Boardman Entertainment. Like split screen multiplayer with him, so that'll be cool. A cool video to record. Yeah. So you're supposed to so you're supposed to do that. And then you just get out of the plane. I mean tank plane. It should be the same plane. Then you're going to the airplane. I like this cool cinematic shot of you leaving. Yeah. Since that level is so short, I just added it to this video. And yeah, we did that in 1 minute 41 seconds. Accuracy is 87.5%. It's pretty good. And yeah, 8 kills total. If you get the infinite weapons sheet, like infinite ammo sheet, and you'll get infinite tank shells, and it's cool just like seeing how long you can survive. So next episode will be the surface. Well, next mission will be the surface, and I'll play that next episode. And yeah, that's pretty much it. See you guys in the next video. Bye.